Time since I posted a video, and it's not because I didn't make any progress on the motorcycle, it's just because I've been so busy that I haven't had time to make a video about the progress. So here you get an update and a look on my paint shop. What I did was bought a sandblasting cabinet. And I have blasted the surface on all the parts. Some of the parts, which is powder coated, they are just a glass blast, so the surface is really rough. So the paint I'm gonna use is gonna stick to it. And other parts are blasted with aluminium oxide. So that's a bit more rough. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna prepare the parts to paint. So I'm gonna use some silicone remover, and if you want to know what I'm using, this product called Spraymax, which is a two-component paint, like you use in a paint shop. So you have this is a epoxy primer, which is, it has a hardener in the bottom, which you push, and then you shake the bottle for a couple of minutes, and then you have 6 hours or something like that to use the whole thing. Yeah, and as I said before, I'm gonna use this silicone remover to remove grease and oil and stuff like that. So hang on, and I will show the progress. Yeah. So as you know, on other YouTube channels and stuff like that, there's a lot of debate on what to use and what to do. If everything was like perfect and I had the time, I would have chosen to go with the powder coating, because it's just so much more doable and so much better. But I didn't have the time to disassemble the engine to the main parts, so I had to spray paint it. And some people use like a compressor and a spray pistol with some two-component paint, but I don't have so much experience in that. Hey, yeah, just a quick update. I actually painted the whole thing this weekend. I did have time for that. So as you can see, I put on the black top coat. And actually, I thought this coat didn't have any like clear in it, but it actually turned out that this top coat was with a clear, so no need for putting a clear on. It looks super good, and it feels quite tough. So hopefully, this paint will last for a long time. I did get a small run here, but it's like nothing, and you wouldn't notice unless you knew. But otherwise, the engine looks amazing, and the other parts look great too. Here we have a final drive arm. It looks really nice, and the center stand right here. Nice gloss. So, yeah, that's nice. Now I just need to finish painting the other parts, and then I can start putting this bike back together. So hopefully I will be able to post a video soon of the progress putting the bike together again. And then of course I will try to make some more content with... It's getting close to assembly time. As you can see, I got everything painted now. Everything I need to assemble the bike. So that's really nice. And I just got a package from Motorworks in the UK with new seals for the cylinder and new O-rings for the final drive and everything. So what I'm gonna do now is start assembling this thing, and I will try to make some short clips showing what progress I do. And then of course when it's all finished, I'm gonna give you a video of the bike assembly and make a really nice video so you can see how good it sounds and what it looks like. Yeah, so as you can see, I got the cylinder heads on the motorcycle now. It was a bit tricky because when you have the camshaft holders off on both sides, you know, these, you have to time the valves so they open at the right moment. So what you do is you remove this whole front cover on the engine right here, and then you are able to see the timing chain. So what you do is that you start with the right side first. You set the timing in the front so you have the right cylinder, and then you have two arrows here on the sprocket, and you set those to be pointed at the direction given in the manual, and then you have a notch in the sprocket and in the camshaft holder that has to be either downwards or upwards for the left side. But it's quite tricky to figure out by using the manual, so it took me some time. But otherwise I have installed the gearbox, installed the final drive and the swing arm, and right now I'm about to install this part of the frame, the front frame, and I will install the airbox and the rear frame. So let's get started with that. Yeah, so I just got the rear frame on, the airbox, the front frame for the forks. I got the forks on and the handlebar. So as you can see, I have mounted my Motor Gadget Motorscope Mini, this is just a holder, on it, and it's great. And then I'm gonna connect all the wiring down here, in one big bundle, so it doesn't interrupt with the steering. And I got the rear wheel on. It's a bit dirty. So as you can see, I'm actually quite happy with my color choice. I went for almost all black on the whole bike, and then I have some small things like the forks and the clamp, fork clamp, and the rear sets in this I can't remember the color name, but it's like a la metallic gray. And actually I just looked at my handlebar when it was mounted, and the color is pretty close to a perfect match, so it couldn't get much better than this. So I'm really looking forward to getting everything assembled and hopefully fire this up. So I will make an update soon on how I'm coming along. So keep an eye out.